Parashat Emor. Parashat Emor comes right after Parashat Kedoshim. The very important command, Kedoshim Tihiyu, you shall be holy. This word holy is a very interesting one. And the question is, really, what does it mean? What does it process? Kedoshim Tihiyu ki kadosh ani Hashem Elokecha. You must be holy because I, your God, am holy. So certainly holiness has to do with God. But I believe in a different way than the way in which most people understand it. Most people, most religions would argue that holiness means leaving the sphere of the human and the physical, transcending it into the sphere of the spiritual, the ethereal, and the world of God. It is an escape from this world into the eternal world. In Judaism, I think it is different. And let's just think about the fact that Emor, which is a parasha of holiness, as we shall see, different kinds of holiness, opens with the laws of the Kohen. And the Kohen is a human being, part of this world, who is in a status of sanctity which is higher than the other families in this world. In the Kohen, you see the sanctity of the human being. And the sanctity of the human being, which is very profound, and it stems from the fact that, as we said, God is identified with the holy. God is within every human being. Vayivra Elokim et ha'adam b'tzalmo. God created the human being in his image. In the image of God created he him. Male and female created he them. There is a part of God within each and every human being. A chelek eloka mimal, a part of the divine from on high. So as soon as we speak about the sacredness of the human being, it's clear that God is desirous, even, as it were, of coming into every human being, of being a real part of every human being. Vayitzer Hashem Elokim et ha'adam afar min ha'adama. God created the human being dust from the earth. Vayipach ba'apav nishmat chayim, and he breathed into the human being the soul breath of life. So what animates the human being with life is the fact that the human being contains a part of God within him. And therefore, if we're looking for the holy, it's not so much our escaping this world into the world of God, but it's God who put himself, as it were, into the world and being of every human. Now, this is true without a question. of the sanctity of the human being because of the God within us. And it's a very important idea because it teaches us that there's a piece of eternality and transcendence, a part of God himself within every human being. And that is eternal. And that means that death is not a total end. So it's God coming into the human being. And in the Kohen, because of the special commandments of the Kohen, there is more of godliness to begin with. Emor then continues with the festivals. The first festival is the Sabbath day. And in that festival, the festival of the Sabbath day, God brings, as it were, his world, his transcendent world, into our world. The Sabbath is a day completely given over to God from this world. In the festivals, we thank God for sanctifying his people. And the festivals commemorate and glorify the historical moments in this world where we saw God, his presence, and his actions in this world. And then we turn to the Mishkan, or the sanctuary. And there we build a house to bring in God. And the vision of Israel is that that house to bring in God will expand into the city of Jerusalem and will ultimately expand into the entire world when every nation will live at least with the morality of Torah and godliness. So therefore, sanctity is not an escape into another world, but it's rather bringing that other world, the world of God, into our present day world, the world of humans. Shabbat Shalom.